Gagne in front. And Langell missed the redirection. And McCleary just blocked the shot by Therrien. And that stings. Into the ribcage.
I'm not so sure it wasn't right into the face.
Ouch.
As McCleary just slid the wrong way. And you can see the pain he is in right now. If you're not close to the point, man, you got to be really careful. Perhaps in the neck is where he got it. He seems to be okay. That is the good thing. This is Hockey Night in Canada, brought to you by Labatt Blue.
Gleason faking the shot. Now it's Malone moving toward the net. His shot knocks Lundqvist down and hit him off the mask, and he's hurting.
Boy, oh boy. I wonder if it didn't catch him underneath on the way up. Sometimes it's just if it just is a stinger. Boy, oh boy. What a dangerous play. Here it is again. Oh, the stick, you know what? The stick,
yeah.
The stick gets under the mask, lifts the mask and the plastic up so that there's just a couple of inches of space, yeah. And that's where the puck goes. That's what happened. I'm going to make sure that his
doctor's checking
jaw's okay.
Yeah.
He's talking. I think he kind of seems to be saying it's the neck, not the jaw. So you know what? I think he's going to stay. Got the look on his face, so he's gonna stay. I think he's
amazing.
You got the team doctor on the ice, you got trainers from both teams on the ice, so they check out everything. They check out the jaw, they check out, and you know, it's a standing ovation.
Listen,
it's so well deserved.
Koivu with another touch on the puck, bounces at the half wall, pushed back to the point. There's a shot by White. Ooh. Oh, that hit one of his teammates who's down. Lanko, I think.
Yeah. I don't know where he got that, but he went down very quickly, and he may have taken that up in the head area. Take a quick look at it. He gets knocked down from in behind. There's the bump, and then there's the shot, and oh, right, looks like it went right off his nameplate. So it kind of caught him in the upper back area, which is an incredibly awkward area to get hit. Just a very peculiar situation. I mean, this is out in the slot. Two guys come together shoulder to shoulder, and he goes down, and then the shot just arrives at that moment. Watch again in front of the net. There he is coming in. Left side of your screen and shoulder to shoulder, and then he goes down, and there's a shot comes in and hits him right on the nameplate. And we certainly wish him well, and we hope that everything was just precaution. There's Wellman, and that's kind of I wouldn't want to say a rude awakening, but you know, you see this at every level, injuries do occur. And
works it on further. Now twisting Kucherov around in front. It was poked away by Holtby. Is gliding across the net mouth, trying to get control with Killorn. Here's McDonough's shot. Oh, and selling out there for Smith Pelly, and he's hurt.
Oh, I got him in the back of the net. This is a really uncomfortable thing to watch from my angle. He's selling out, as Doc says, and this is not pretty. Eddie and Doc have talked about guys doing whatever it takes to win a trophy. Devontae Smith-Pelly goes into this thing, and watch how he turns and look where the puck gets him off the shoulder and then the back of the net.
Watch this in real speed. Ryan McDonough, who takes that shot, and you're going down anticipating it's going to go around your shin pads or the midsection there, and Smith-Pelly just kind of off his angle a little bit, turning, doing whatever it takes, and catching that in the back of the head, and hopefully he is going to be okay, because he was outstanding in that game six back in D.C.
Young offensive defenseman for the Red Wings being chased here by Lamico, and he turned it over to Pesek, who gives to McCann, breaking in shorthanded. McCann with a shot save. Rebound, McCann scores! the first shorty of the season. And they make it a 3-1 game, and Jimmy Howard was shaken up on the play after making the initial save.
On what ended up being a rebound off the McCann initial shot. Watch him here. Shot, he's hurt right there. And he was not able to make any kind of a move to try and get over. And that was a no-brainer for McCann, who initiated the first shorthanded goal.
And he knocked Curry out of the goal crease area. Good chance there for Edmonton. Back is Iserman. Leaving it. Gallant a drive, pure injured. On a high shot by Gallant. Hit him up around the neck area. And Grant Fuhr is down on the ice and injured on a hard shot by Gallant. And the first guy there to see if he was all right was Gerard Gallant.
What a blast this was. A 3-on-2 was dropped into the slot. And it's a rising rocket. And just beneath the throat of Grant Fuhr is where he got that shot. And I think he's in shock more than anything else. And we'll see Gallant, you see Fuhr lift right up immediately and take the shot. And he appears to be all right. Peter Miller out, helping him out. You see that turtleneck thing he wears just below the strap on his mask? It's something devised by the Oiler training staff, and the protection there is probably what saved him.
With a comfortable 3-0 lead, Tkachuk takes one up high in the side of the head. And Matthew Tkachuk, that might be off the neck as he's going to make his way to the bench and right to the room.
Well, I tell you, he's a tough kid. He knew right away that he didn't like the way that one hit him. Just comes immediately up and hits him in that left ear neck area. And you'll see it here, just the bobbling puck comes back and trying to put it deep. You're right in the back of the neck, Rick. You're right. As he turned his head, he saw it. So he was able to see this puck coming, gets his head turned, catches him back under the ear in the neck area. And good on him to get off the ice and in quick steps to get some attention.
Ben stays with him, stride for stride. McCarr to the right. It's a durable one-timer. That hit Klingberg upstairs. He's down. Concern for John Klingberg. The whistle is blown.
Dave Zeiss, who's got to be top 10 in time on ice for the Stars in the young season, with all the trots out to attend to players he's had to do, and Klingberg is taking some time. Zadorov came in to check on him. They brought McKinnon up top. They love to do that, bring a forward up top. This is so reminiscent of the shot that buckled Sagan in Denver, because the shot by Zadorov was going a mile wide again, but it was up high, caught John up in the head. Man, oh man, right in the cheek. Big heavy shot from the blue line.